sec. Let me call for backup. This is car 4604 requesting a backup at Pier 14.
Yeah! And what can I do for you?
Figure it out.
I got no money. It all goes down that slot into a safe. I don't know the combination. the boss don't trust me.
In the 2-2 precinct, we got a 10:30 in progress. Silent alarm at Julio's Bodega at 725 14th Street.
This one's for us.
Shit.
I need money.
Look, no money. Like merchandise. Anything you want in the store.
Dios mío, and that's gonna be you all over the walls in a minute. So, when does your boss come in to open up the safe, huh?
6:30.
Oh, wait.
Okay.
But you don't have to hang around. Why don't you try running for the door, huh?
No. No, it's okay. I stay.
Hey, let's open up some lotto tickets, huh?
Sure, see. Okay. Yeah,
maybe I'll be a winner.
Okay.
I feel lucky.
Nada, mira, nothing.
Well, keep going.
Okay. Nothing again.
We'll go through the whole bunch, eh?
Okay. Nothing. Nada.
No, I think you're lying.
No, I'm calling him the way he's coming up.
Okay.
Nothing. Nada.
No, I think I'm a winner.
I'm telling you. Holy shit. Ay, Dios mío. Mira, $5,000. $5,000. Huh? You win $5,000. Thank God you got here. Can you believe it? The fucker just won $5,000. I mean, I guess he don't win it. I guess I win it, huh? Like they say, huh? Goodness is his own reward, huh?
What for?
Forrest, Officer Mallory, you've been cleared of all wrongdoing. In fact, you're gonna get commendations for your actions.
So, does that mean we're back on active duty again?
Not just yet.
Commissioner, what about Cordell?
What about Cordell?
You didn't find the body in the river because it wasn't there.
Current must have swept it out to sea.
No, he's still alive.
You're starting with these ghost stories again?
Cordell died in Sing Sing more than 2 years ago.
want you to see this police psychologist.
What?
Her name is Susan Riley. She's got an excellent record helping officers readjust.
Oh, come on, Commissioner. We're not crazy.
Of course not. So you shouldn't have any objections seeing Officer Riley. She's a cop, too. I set up a meeting for tomorrow at 3 o'clock. Be there.
Yeah, we've got a 3 o'clock appointment. Officers Mallory and Forrest, we're a little early, I guess.
That's right. Why don't we go get a cup of coffee?
Are you going to find us unfit to go back on the job?
Well, I hope not. What do you think?
Well, I think we're both just as sane as you are.
Well, then you both realize that this Matt Cordell was killed in prison.
Yeah, right. But you see, we both just saw him on the pier. So what? Does that make us nuts?
What you saw was a very large man with a horribly disfigured face. And did he say he was Cordell?
No, he never spoke.
Well, then it could have been anyone in policeman's uniform, right? A homicidal maniac. Grudge against the police force, maybe.
Hey, look, you know, if this is the official line that the department's going to use, great.
No, that's a lie.
Would you excuse us for a second?
Certainly.
Teresa, all I know about is being a cop, and I don't know about you, but I need this job. You know, when you think about it, I mean, what the hell difference does it make who he was?
Because you can't kill the dead.
Tari, let her go. Doc, do me a favor, will you? Don't put that in your report.
Jack, I'm afraid I'm going to have to give her a negative evaluation.
Come on, let me at least just talk to her, will you? She'll come around.
I cannot let anyone out in the street that's got a gun with emotional problems.
McKinney! You okay?
Never better.
We were covering the front.
That's why I came around back.
Too bad you didn't kill him!
Yeah, too much fucking paperwork.
Lieutenant McKinney?
Yeah.
Come on in, have a seat.
Thought there'd be a couch.
Just a chair.
Yeah.
So how you doing?
Not bad. You know, I haven't been to confession in over 20 years. But if the priests looked like you, I probably would have gone more often. Mind if I smoke?
Actually, I do. Thank you. So, do you want to tell me about the shooting?
Well, what's there to say? I mean, I shot him before he shot me. Look, doctor, let's make this easy. I feel great about what I did. If you want to psychoanalyze someone, why don't you psychoanalyze the lawyers and judges who put that kind of scum back on the streets?
First of all, I'm not a doctor. I'm a clinical psychologist. And I realize you're here under protest.
Well, that's good. So you can tell me how long my ass has to warm this chair before I satisfy the mandatory requirements.
Well, every officer involved in a shooting has to see one of us for counseling at least once.
Okay, I've been seen. Counseled me. Thank you.
Excuse me, Lieutenant. Did you have a partner? Sergeant Joseph Minnelli?
Yeah. Joe and I were a team.
He made an appointment with me once about 6 months ago. He phoned and requested help. That's a little unusual, isn't it? One of you asking for help?
Well, he was a sensitive guy.
I never found that out. He stood me up, never showed. It was a Friday. The following night, he committed suicide with his service revolver.
I know all about that. I found the body Monday morning.
I didn't know that.
Well, there's a lot of things you people don't know.
Well, someone talked him out of showing up here. Probably told him he'd be a wimp if he admitted something was bothering him.
What are you getting at?
You tell me. Please don't slam the...
They tell me they got your picture in the paper. I guess congratulations are in order.
That's not such a bad picture. Tell you what, Harry, I'll take a dozen of them.
A dozen it is. How often do I get a celebrity around here?
Okay, now, Harry, give me your hand. Okay, look, this is a five, okay? You trust me?
I trust you.
All right, you keep the change.
Thank you, thank you. All right.
Okay, let's see what they said about Therese.
What's going on? What's happening? Jack, oh, talk to me! Police!
Strangle like the rest. All strippers. Sure picks the pretty ones. Look, Trey, you look sick.
Oh, I hate being around stiffs ever since they made me kiss my grandmother at the funeral.
Could you do it, please?
Mother in Florida.
Theresa, can you think of anyone with a motive to kill Jack? You were at the lounge in headquarters. You had an argument. You got angry. You walked out. Where did you go?
Home.
You didn't wait outside the building and try to make up with him?
I'd have no reason to kill him. I loved him.
Well, maybe you loved him too much, huh? Maybe you thought you were cracking up. You know, he didn't want to marry you. You got angry.
This is bullshit. Why don't you ask Commissioner Doyle who killed Jack?
Look, I'm just following procedure. Okay, you know as well as I, 9 out of 10 times, the prime suspects are usually family, relatives, or friends. That's where you find the killer.
You bastards.
I don't like what you're asking me to do, officer. I know as well.
We're just doing it for the good of the department. We don't even consider her a suspect. Just our way of putting her on the defensive for a while. Keep her under control so she doesn't go to the papers.
My time would be better spent finding out who killed Jack.
Your time, detective, is to put more pressure on her. That's a direct order.
I don't like it either.
You should talk. Your report described her as mentally unsound and unfit for duty.
How am I supposed to really judge her? I mean, she's out there on the streets being a cop. I sit behind my desk like a social worker.
Well, I just don't like people who try and get inside other people's heads.
Yeah, you made that very clear to me in my office yesterday. Is there any particular reason?
My wife was under the care of a psychiatrist for over a year. You know, standard problems, cop's wife. Now, I admit I'm not the easiest guy to live with, but she couldn't make a move without him. Stopped communicating with me, only him. Now she's my ex-wife. Is that reason enough for you?
I'm sure the doctor was just doing what he thought was best.
I don't buy into the psychology stuff. I think you're all full of shit, so you can take your Carl Jung and Sigmund Freud and shove them up your ass. Just to clear up matters. I talked Joe Minnelli into canceling that appointment with you. And I don't feel guilty about it.
How could you feel guilty? You're a cop.
So are you.
Sakes, you already did it. Hey, come on. Can't we talk about this? I'll move the car. I was just coming back to move the car.
I got here first.
Yeah, but I'm here. I'm right here. You can't tow me away.
Read the back of your summons.
Hey, look, you're all alone. Can't we work this out just between you and me, huh?
What? Are you offering me a bribe?
Not at all. But if you tow my car, I won't be able to get to work tomorrow. I'll lose a whole day.
You can afford it.
You enjoy this. You son of a bitch. You got a shitty, nothing civil service job. Oh, careful of my fender with that. This is a new paint job. I just had the whole thing whacked. You'll be towing fucking cars the rest of your life, you know that? You'll never be anything. You can't even do this stupid job right. I'd like to see the piece of shit you drive.
You better start thinking about getting out to Brooklyn early tomorrow to reclaim this beauty. A lot of cars get stripped in our lot. The stereo, the tires, the whole engine. That's why I wouldn't own a car in this town.
Harry.
Night. Happy holiday.
Here you go, Harry. Night. Excuse me. Hi. I'd like to talk to you.
Do I know you?
I'm from the police department.
I talked to the cops already enough.
I'm not an investigator like the others. I'm a psychologist. I'm trying to do a profile on this killer.
I've got nothing to say. I'm trying to make a living.
Maybe you could tell from his footsteps if he's a large man or perhaps he said something.
No footsteps. I just heard Jack screaming, and that's all.
Did you touch him? Not the victim, the killer.
Why'd you ask me that?
You did, didn't you? Tell me.
I lost my sight in combat in Sicily. A German grenade went off in my face, killed all the others in the foxhole around me. I lay there more than a day. Surrounded by these dead bodies, buried in them. At night, they froze. Them being on top of me kept me from freezing too. I never thought I'd feel anything like that again. Frozen, dead flesh. And then I touched his hand. Just for a second, mind you, and I was back there again, with the dead.
Ow! You killed him, you son of a bitch! Ow! Take it easy! Look, if he wanted to tow my car, so what? You don't kill anybody over bullshit like that!
Well, if you didn't kill him, who the fuck did?
You wouldn't believe me!
Why don't you try me, punk?
All right, all right! He was a great big cop. 6'3", maybe more. All scarred up, and he never said a word.
You know something? I don't believe you.
Get the fuck out of here.
Take a look at these reports. It's happening again.
I got in this job 2 weeks ago. Give me a break.
Talking about a man who killed your predecessor. A man who may try to pull the same number on you.
Then the wrong guy died in that truck in the river.
When this leaks out, people are not going to want to pick up the phone and dial 911. They're going to want to defend themselves. We're looking at a bloodbath here. Citizens blowing each other away like there isn't any law.
Tell me the truth. Do you think it's a cop? Some officer that's gone off the deep end?
Doesn't fit the description of any cop I know. 6'3", scars all over.
Except one.
Don't say it. Don't even think it.
What are you talking about?
Nothing. Nothing. We've got to get this killer. Better assemble a new task force. Get some aid from the governor.
Well, I got a lead. This policewoman, Teresa Mallory.
Mallory? Oh, my God. Not her again.
Yeah, her. Killed her boyfriend. I think he's going to go after her.
I don't get it. He's had a lot of opportunities to kill her. Why hasn't he killed her?
Maybe he enjoys making her afraid.
I'm beginning to think maybe you're not so crazy.
Wait. And you'll be out of a job, too.
They've asked me to certify you unfit, but I can't do it.
I read all about Cordell and what happened to him.
Look, if you want more information, just tune in the Criminals at Large television show tonight.
Why would you go on that show?
Why not? They alert the public to wanted criminals. A half dozen or so have been caught or turned in as a direct result.
And who's going to believe you, the lunatic fringe?
Will you come with me?
I can't. What are you going to say?
There's my cab.
All right, I'll go with you. I'll even pay for the cab.
Oh, where to, girls?
Mayflower Hotel.
Sounds good to me. Just jumped out to get a pack of smokes. I hope you girls won't wait in the cold too long.
No, it's okay.
You know, when I saw the bag, I said, this is a run to the airport. Guess you can't win them all.
I don't see anyone following us, Teresa.
Some ex-boyfriend giving you a hard time?
Yeah, sort of.
The shows are going to be letting out now. Maybe I can beat the crosstown traffic if I cut down this way.
No, stay on the busy streets.
Hey, what's going on here?
You ever seen one of these?
Yeah, I seen plenty of them. And it usually means I ain't getting a tip. Damn.
What's the matter?
I don't know. I think one of my tires is going flat.
Driver, just stay in the car. Don't get out.
You kidding?
Drive.
On my rim?
Teresa, take it easy. Anybody can get a flat tire.
Look, cop or no cop, I own this cab. I'm not gonna fuck it up for anybody. Shit!
You're making it worse than it has to be. Nobody's following us.
Just stay in the cab. When you left your cab to go for cigarettes, somebody must rescue your tires.
Damn kids, I'll bet. Where the hell are you going?
Teresa, stop it! What are you doing?
I knew it! I never should have let cops in my cab!
I don't know.
Teresa!
Are you all right in there? Hey, who handcuffed you, lady? What the hell is going on?
One person.
All right, easy does it. We'll get you out of there.
Radio in for a Hacksaw up here. We got to get these cuffs off of her.
What are you doing? Who the hell
is just take it easy. We're going to get you out of there. Relax.
You better lie still. Your wrist is broken.
Better fix me up quickly. I gotta be on TV in a few hours.
I'm Detective McKinney. I'm gonna ride inside. You okay? I was on my way to Teresa's apartment when the report came over the radio.
So you don't have to worry about her doing any more talking.
I'm not feeling too great about all this.
I doubted her in the beginning, too. But I saw him. I saw what he did.
What'd you see? Big guy in a bulletproof vest dressed up like a cop.
Sean, I saw Matt Cordell.
Tonight, Criminals at Large goes after a serial killer who's claimed the lives of beautiful young girls working as exotic dancers and strippers in New York City. And you, the audience, may help us to catch him.
Welcome to Club 69, here in the heart of Times Square. I'm your MC.
Tonight, you'll meet detectives assigned to this case, but first, I would like you to meet Deputy Commissioner Edward Doyle of the NYPD.
Do you want another drink?
Just what has your department done about this case so far?
We've contacted and alerted the young women who seem to be the killer's prime target group.
We have a special late guest here. Actually, she's one of your lady cops. She's also a police psychologist and her name is Officer Susan Riley. Susan, welcome to the show.
Thank you. Mr. Brady, the murders of these exotic dancers is a very tragic situation. Now, my concern is another series of killings going on that's being covered up.
Pardon me. Mr. Brady, this is utterly nonsense.
The so-called maniac cop did not drown in the river as reported.
Well, Commissioner, what do you have to say about this?
Well, the homicides that Officer Riley is talking about were deliberately set up to imitate the earlier killings.
And tell me something, Commissioner. Why has this been kept from the public and the press? Hmm?
The killer craves publicity. We're denying him that. We hope that his behavior will become foolhardy. Or he'll expose himself, show himself. Then we expect to nail him.
Mr. Commissioner, why don't you just admit that Matt Cordell is responsible for these killings?
Cordell died in prison.
Brain dead, but still breathing when his body was released. He recovered and came back to revenge himself upon the police department and the city officials who railroaded him into jail in the first place. You know how many people have been murdered already, and yet the replacements still insist upon hiding the facts? Commissioner's trying to...
We're out of time here. We're going to cut you off. And, Punk, if you happen to be out there listening, I just want you to remember this. When it comes time for your execution, you can't con. Con Edison.
Have any
good night.
Some of the hosts here. To help you.
Roger, you want to give me a hand with these cables?
Okay, EJ, let me kill
you. Officer Riley.
Okay, thanks.
That was a pretty stupid thing you did up there, young lady. I'm going to see that you're suspended.
Teresa Mallory's dead because she knew the truth. Let me tell you something, Commissioner. Cordell's going to pay you a visit, and you'll see him. Just like I did.
Oh, boys, look at this Blondie. Isn't she beautiful? Take him out, Blondie. Take him out. Let him freeze. Oh, boys, aren't they lovely? Ooh, baby. And on the other side, he has Red. Take him out, Red. Let him breathe through. And be generous, boys, with that cash, because these girls are dancing here just for you. Oh, let's have a round of applause for these two lovely young ladies. And don't forget, they'll be back later, boys. We're open 24 hours. Don't go nowhere. Hang around. And now, for the first time on any stage, the lovely Cheryl. Oh, let's have a big round of applause, boys. Come on, let's hear it for Cheryl. Making her debut here in the big city at Club 69. Isn't she lovely? No one has ever had this girl on the stage before. We always are the first one with the best talent in New York. So just keep your eyes on Cheryl. Oh, boys, tell me, isn't she lovely? Just keep your eyes on her. You'll definitely get an eye for her. Oh, God, she's gorgeous, boys. Be generous. Spread out that cash.
Plenty of room for advancement.
Are you eating well?
Yes, I'm getting plenty to eat. They have an employee cafeteria. Well, I'm sharing this lovely apartment with a few of the girls from the secretarial pool. Yeah, they're really sweet. Okay, well then, as soon as I get my phone, I'll give you a call and give you the number. All right, okay. But in the meantime, please, just don't worry about me. I'm fine.
Love you, sweetheart. Take care of yourself.
Okay. Owen, give my love to Dad.
I will, sweetheart.
All right.
I love you.
I love you, too. Bye.
Bye.
course my typing's getting better, Mom.
Who is it?
Who is it? So you better get out of here.
I feel a giant fucking wave! Now, you got to listen to me. Listen to me! Now, I've been watching you, and I say, you're asking for it. Right? Tell me! Come on!
The police are coming.
I don't care about no police. This ain't gonna take long.
What are you gonna do?
Think about it. What do you think I'm gonna do to you, huh? Come on! What do you think? What do you think?
You killed those other girls.
No. Let's just say that I need another 8x10 glossy from my collection. Oh, I had to do some dirt to me. Huh, baby? Well, I love the way you feel. Oh, yeah. You got to be proud because you're the prettiest one in my collection so far. You are. And the best man should clear out. You could be in a Broadway show, but no, you got to be up there on that stage dancing like some whore. So you never know what type of person's gonna walk in down, do you, honey?
That's the lobby. They're coming up to catch you.
It's a slow elevator. It's only gonna take a minute. Paul, you ain't no cop, man. I know who you are. Damn, she was talking about you on TV. You was in the headlines last month and everything. See, you're front page stuff. But me, I'm back on page 5. You know why? You know what did it for you? That uniform. See, that was a gimmick. See, that's what got their attention. I got a real nice apartment. I mean, it's quiet. Nobody ever comes down there. Private, you know? You can come there. I mean, I ain't queer or nothing. See, but you be safe there. And I got a collection to show you. The city at night. That's where and when I do my work. You know, I feel like I'm a crusader against the whores of the world. That's me. Turkel, crusader tonight. You don't talk much, but that's okay. Was it the accident, same one that screwed your face up? I didn't mean to offend you now. I'm sorry if I did. Yes, here's my place. Home sweet home. These are my girls. They ain't gonna dance in front of nobody no more. Now they're Turkell's girls. My first name is Steven. Why don't you go ahead and sit down? You know, most of the time, I just talk to myself anyway. So this is okay. I mean, I don't hear voices or nothing. I'm not like those guys that hear angels and devils telling them what to do. See, I know what to do.
Hey, we'll have a drink.
You hate cops. So,
you made a fucking mockery out of them. I mean, for a while, everybody was scared shit to walk up to a cop in this here town. And that was because of you. You know, I never thought really that I'd meet you. Or that we'd become friends. All right. Why should you trust me? I got to earn it. I got to make you respect me. But I think maybe you see the possibilities in me, huh? Can you write? I mean, can you write down your name? See, that way I'll know what to call you. I'll go get a pencil and paper. Cordell, that's the name she said on TV.
So, how'd you like me on TV?
I loved you. I mean, I loved you. The city council was nuts about you. Yeah. Check out your reviews. The whole city's freaked over this maniac cop.
I guess I really started something, huh? Maybe I should just go home and wait for the axe to fall.
No chance.
So you mean I can't earn more guest shots?
No.
You think there's any reason why Cordell would want to come back and get me?
I don't know. But let me tell you, if he doesn't shoot you, the commissioner himself might kill you. Why?
This stupid rhyme keeps going through my head. We used to say it when we were kids in Brooklyn. I mean, it's just nonsense, but I can't get it out of my mind. It goes, one bright day in the middle of the night, two dead boys got up to fight. Back to back, they faced each other. With their knives, they shot each other. Deaf policemen heard the noise and came and killed the two dead boys. You know that?
Yeah, I remember that when I was a kid. Two dead boys. What about it?
I don't know. I guess I'm just cracking up.
You ought to know. That's your specialty.
Yeah. Did you ever see anything so nasty? Ooh, you got a big one too. Boy, they really did a job on you, Cordell. I mean, honest cop, what'd you think you'd get out of it? You put the squeeze on the important people, you end up in the slammer, not them. What happened to you? Why don't you tell me what happened? I mean, I've never seen nobody cut that bad, that deep. Still be breathing. Thank you.
This young lady was attacked last evening by the man we believe killed those strippers in Brooklyn, Queens, and Manhattan.
What can I do to help?
Tonight we're hitting similar clubs in Lower Manhattan, bringing Cheryl here along, hoping she can identify her attacker. If he frequents such clubs, we think he does, he might show up.
We're going to be going in and out of these places as couples. So we need a policewoman to make a foursome.
I don't have any experience in the streets. Why me?
Her assailant was rescued by a cop who killed two policemen in the process. A huge, disfigured cop.
We put out a story that Cheryl died en route to Bellevue, just to put her attacker at ease.
Did he do this to you?
Yes.
Could you tell me what his hands felt like?
Like ice.
So you want to come along?
Do I have any choice?
No. You're under my protection. Remember how to use a gun, Officer Riley?
What difference does it make? Shooting Cordell's only good for getting his attention.
Someplace I can't go, huh? Got work to do. Yeah, but you're coming back, right? You know, I got things to do myself, but then I'll be back here waiting for you.
Money do you make, Lieutenant?
Maybe I ought to take dancing lessons.
You see anybody familiar here?
Just a bunch of regulars from the other clubs that I work, but I don't see him.
Why don't we get out of here and try someplace else?
Why don't we have a drink? What the hell, we paid for it.
Lieutenant, it's him.
Hey, watch it.
Hey.
Hey, look out.
Oh.
Gotta get me one of those.
Hey, you. I want to see my lawyer.
There's no problem. What happened to your friend, a big cop?
He's my friend, all right. And he ain't going to forget about me.
How did you meet Cordell?
How'd you know his name? Shit, that girl that cold copped me. She's the one from that TV show, Criminals at Large. Hey, you. It's going to take more than a TV show to catch my friend.
Is this your address there, Cal?
Wipe your feet on a mat!
I think we got him.
That's great. You want some company?
Haven't you seen enough action for one night? Why don't you go get some rest?
No, I couldn't sleep. I think I'll go fire a group practice rounds. I've never been much good with guns.
Under the circumstances, I try to improve.
I've never seen you in uniform before.
I wanted to see if it still fits.
That's not a very good shot pattern. Maybe you're better at shooting your mouth off on TV. Did they assign you to a beat yet? Maybe Spanish Harlem or some nice place like that?
Maybe.
Well, listen, Susan, just keep trying. You'll get the knack of it in about a year or two. Just tell everybody that broken arm was your good one.
Right.
Come on in, fellas.
Ourselves a serial killer.
Don't you forget me, Cordell. I'm waiting for you here, Cordell. We'll both probably end up in hell. You need...
Motherfucker! Will you hold it down? I get back in the motherfucking death house.
Is that where you're going, man? Sing Sing?
What the fuck are you? Barbara Walters? Shit. Yeah. Oh, fucking morning. Shit. I stalled them motherfuckers for 5 years. Yeah. The Supreme Court had fucked me. And wouldn't even save sex. Cruel, unusual punishment. No bullshit. Listening to assholes like you is worse.
Hey, be nice. When my friend comes to break me out, I might take you with me.
Yeah. I'ma hold my breath in my dick.
Oh, hi there, pretty lady. Boy, don't you look great in that uniform. You want me to autograph your cast?
Look, I still want to talk to you about Cordell.
If you want to know about him, stick around here tonight. You may learn something.
What do you mean by that?
Thank you. must be visiting hours, because my friend is back!
And make sure that roadblock is set up.
What's going on?
He blew away half a dozen men downstairs on the firing range. I don't know how many he killed upstairs. We just got the hell out of his way.
That's a good strategy.
He's got Susan Riley as a hostage on the cell block.
Is she all right?
I don't know.
What are we doing about this?
We got the tactical squad on its way and a couple of SWAT teams. Doyle's been notified. He's on his way over here to take charge.
Take charge? That's a joke.
You got any ideas?
If he comes out, don't interfere with him. Just follow him. He had a reason for coming here. He's got a reason for everything he does.
Ooh, what'd you do to these cops? What, I love to see it. See, Blood? I told you, treat me nice.
She's gonna get us killed.
Hey, lady. Close your eyes. You may see something you like.
Go well home. How come you don't talk? It's weird. Weird!
He just handed me your transfer papers to Sing Sing.
I ain't going back there.
Well, I think that's what he's got in mind.
And they wanna kill me!
Oh, he wouldn't let that happen to a pleasing personality like yourself.
You've been in Sing Sing before. What's back there for you?
Come on, you're a bright girl. Haven't you got that figured out yet? We're going there to break out all them guys on death row. There's about 20 of them up there on appeal. Real lovable types. Yes, that's what we're going to do. Because we're recruiting. And aren't we? Aren't we? Sure. See, because it's like your thoughts are in my mind. I got you figured out, man. We ain't running away. Nah, we're getting stronger.
Yeah!
Because we got ourselves a leader.
Well, I don't want a part of this. I'm not going to do this damn thing.
Say, listen. You going to bring her along? All right, sweetheart. Here's the jacket. You lead the way. If there's any shooting, you'll be the first to know about it.
Terrific. She puts on a uniform and immediately gets taken hostage. What's up, cop?
Why is he shut up? Get in!
We gotta talk.
I have my limo.
We need to talk.
Go going in the wrong direction. That's the parkway up ahead.
Same route Cordell took. I think I know where he's going.
How do you know that?
One of the escapees was scheduled for a transfer to the death house at Sing Sing. Cordell's making the delivery. He's homesick.
How come you didn't say anything about that before?
Because all the cops in the world can't stop Cordell. Only you can.
Stop this car. I'm getting out. It's an order.
You lost the right to make orders. You're going with me.
No, I'm not going anywhere.
What's the matter, Commissioner? You finally believe in ghosts? You order. You made him one.
Turn this goddamn car around.
That's a dumb fucking thing to do.
Well, what do you want me to do, huh? Shove the gun in my own mouth? Pull the trigger?
That's too easy. I want you to reopen the Cordell case. Get some judge to set aside his conviction and then dig up his empty coffin. That's right, it's gonna be empty.
Come on.
Then I want you to bury it again with a police honor
guard.
You're
fucking crazy, you know that?
Cordell got too close to you people at City Hall who were taking payoffs. So you framed him, put him in a fucking rat hole and set him up. You murdered him.
You're pushing me too far, McKinney. Pull over! You're right. I'm responsible. What am I supposed to do now?
You sign a confession.
I can't do that. I'd be through.
When you're through now, you're not going to see retirement. He's going to come after you.
Michelle is pretty for a cop. You want to integrate?
Wants to speak to His Honor, the mayor. It concerns the massacre at headquarters.
Put me through to the warden. Warden Blum's just been delivered.
I got word from the city that he'd been broken out of jail.
Well, he just arrived on the escort.
Seal off that section of the cell block. Put all men on alert. We're in trouble.
Yes, sir.
Attention. This is the warden. Deputy Commissioner Doyle wishes to speak to Mac Cordell.
Cordell? He's alive. I told you so. Comes after me, I'm ready for that bastard.
Deputy Commissioner Doyle.
I'm here in the prison courtyards. I'm talking to Matt Cordell. Cordell.
Judge Arthur Claypool has ordered your case reopened.
Bullshit. Like you need a new trial, right?
Listen, Cordell, this is what you want.
Hey, you shut up. You hear me?
Listen!
Keep going.
In your first trial, perjury was committed.
Even the presiding judge was influenced.
I myself was involved. We're the guilty ones.
Cordell, you were a good man once. A good cop.
Fuck him. Good cop. You're every good cop's nightmare.
Yeah!
Cordell, I repeat.
Your conviction will be reversed by the state Supreme Court.
Open this door, man!
I'm the guilty one.
Good. Here, Roger. I hope.
Brother Matthew to you, Lord. May he live on in your presence. In your mercy and love, forgive whatever sins he may have committed through human weakness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And so the final remains of Matthew Cordell, who died 3 years ago, are brought to rest with honors. His remains have been brought here so he may be placed beside his fellow officers. But I feel sorrow for all of those whose deceptions and lies were responsible for this tragic death. That's something they'll have to contend with when they meet their maker.
Detail. Attention. Present arms. Order. Arms.
I'll take that.
Detail dismissed.
What is it?
No, nothing. There's a piece of Cordell in every cup. Every time arresting some mutt isn't enough, because we know they'll be back on the streets before we even do the paperwork. Every time we pull a trigger, and it feels good, because that's something the lawyers can't reverse. It all comes down to justice and pressure. There's only that much difference between a cop and a maniac cop.
Trốn im hơi, đường đến trường em.